You are here.
Hey guys, welcome to E Recharge Wednesday. My name is Pastor Obedience, and we are bringing the word right to you this Wednesday. I want us to pray together, and we want to pray that may the word of God penetrate through your heart. May your faith arise. You know it is our faith season, and we're getting back right again in the word of faith, a word of courage, a word of exhortation. Close your eyes with me as we pray. Father, in the name of the Lord, we pray that, oh God, may you speak your word. We don't speak our own word, message, oh God, but oh God, may we speak that which you have deposited in my heart. Speak to me and speak through me. We pray for the audience that will be watching today, Almighty God, that, oh God, you shall be relevant to somebody's situation. May you revive somebody. May you, mighty God, penetrate in somebody's situation and let faith arise. In the name of Jesus Christ, we are praying. And let everybody say, amen. Right. The word of the Lord has just come upon my spirit, and I believe that this word is going to be relevant to your life. And may God help me that today I don't preach, I just want us to talk and just get into the word of God and understand what God is saying. Today we'll be speaking about desperate faith. Desperate faith. Faith that is desperate. You know, I went to the Oxford Dictionary and I just picked up this definition, and the dictionary says, the word desperate means having a great need or desire for something. Having a great need or desire for something. And I want to speak to somebody today, somebody who is desperate for a miracle, somebody who is desperate for a move of God, desperate for a solution, desperate for a breakthrough in your life. Your faith needs to be desperate. When you are desperate, you don't care what people are saying around you. When you are desperate, you don't care about the surrounding around you. When you are desperate, you don't care about the status that has surrounded you. Even when people are continuing with their lives, but for you, it's not business as usual. That's the kind of people that I want to talk to today. Faith that is desperate. Now, let's go to the word. The book of Mark chapter number 2. Mark chapter 2, verse number 1 up to verse number 5. We will also read Mark chapter 10, verse number 47 up to verse number 48. And we will get right into it. The Bible says in Mark chapter 2, verse number 1 up to verse number 5. Again he entered Capernaum after some days, and it was heard that he was in the house. Underline the word in the house. Immediately many gathered together, so that there was no longer room to receive them, not even near the door. And he preached the word to them. And they came to him, bringing a paralytic who was carried by four men. And when they could not come near him because of the crowd, they uncovered the roof where he was. So when they had broken through, they let down the bed on which the paralytic was lying. Verse number 5. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Son, your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven." Let me read verse 6 to you. And some of the scribes were sitting there and reasoning in their hearts, "Why does this man speak blasphemies like this? Who can forgive sins but God alone?" Who can forgive sins but God alone? Mark chapter 10, verse number 47 and 48, 49. When he heard it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." Verse 48. Then many warned him to be quiet, and he cried out all the more, underline the words, all the more, "Son of David, have mercy on me." So Jesus stood still and commanded him to be called. Then they called the blind man, saying to him, "Be of good cheer, rise, he is calling you." And throwing aside his garment, he rose and came to Jesus. The desperate faith. Now the Bible presents to us here that Jesus entered a village called Capernaum. And when people heard that Jesus was in the city, Jesus was in the house, the Bible says immediately people started gathering. Remember, Jesus did not make an announcement that he was coming to Capernaum, but people immediately heard that he was there. And I want you to watch it. The Bible says in verse 2, immediately they gathered together. Now you must ask yourself, who are the people that gathered around Jesus? Who are the people that gathered together? You know, I want to imagine this. Allow me to imagine the Bible. When the Bible says they gathered around him, which means it was those that were able to gather around him, which means it was those that could come. They had, but they and they had the ability to come to him. But this must also tell us that there are also those that had that he is there, but they could not, they did not have the ability to come to him. And the fact that you don't have the ability to come to him does not mean that Jesus is not there. Jesus is in the house. You want to come to him, but you cannot get to him. Remember what Paul says? He says that the things that I want to do, those are the things that I don't do. And the things that I don't want to do, those are the things that I keep on doing. Same applies here. There were those that wanted to come to him, but they could not come to him. But I want you to watch this. The Bible says, when those that could come came, the Bible says, number one, there was no longer room to receive them. There was no longer room to receive them. Which means the space that Jesus was in had limited capacity. Oh my God. It could only take a certain number of people. It was first come, first served. Remember the man that was sitting by the pool of Bethesda? Jesus asked and says, do you want to be made whole? Do you want to be healed? And he said, I can't get to the water when the angel comes to stir up the water. I don't have anyone to take me there. There are others that have people to help them, because it was the first person that jumps into the water that will be healed. I can't jump in there. And it was so here. When Jesus entered Capernaum, it was first come, first serve. Those that arrived quickly there, they were the ones that filled the room. The Bible says there was no longer room. Underline that. You need to note this down. There was no longer room in that place. There was no longer room to receive them. And the Bible says, not even near the door. And he preached the word to them. Hello. And the Bible says, Jesus continued preaching the word, but there was no room. I don't know where you want to enter, and there's no room for you. I don't know where you want to go, where you wish yourself to be, where you desire yourself to be, but there is no room for you to receive you. Oh, let me tell you something. Right in the midst of a place where there is no room to receive you, a desperate faith can make a way where there is no way. Oh God, help me this. Help me that I deliver this word to you. The Bible says there was no longer room to them, but Jesus preached to them. Jesus, you are preaching, but there is no room. You are preaching, but others are not here. Listen, verse number 3, the Bible says, and they came to him. Now watch this. The Bible says, they came to him, bringing a paralytic who was carried by four men. Oh my God. Now, this is another character that we find in this story. A paralytic also heard that Jesus was in the house. Jesus was in the city, but he could not get there himself. The Bible says four men had to bring him there. Four men had to bring him to where Jesus was. Now watch this. The Bible says, four men carried him there. Verse number 4. And when they could not come near him because of the crowd, when the men left, when they killed the paralytic, the Bible says they were coming to Jesus. They wanted to get near. near to Jesus. The man that was lying there, the man that they were carrying there, the Bible describes him as a paralytic, which means if you are a paralytic, you could not move any part of your body. Speaking, you could speak. Seeing, you could see, but you could not move anywhere. What do you do when your faith can move? When your faith cannot act? When your faith is lying dormant? When your faith is inactive? Number one, and very important, it is very important whom you surround yourself in a place where hope is all gone. Whom you surround yourself when faith is non-existent. There are times, children of God, wherein you feel like you can't pray. There are times, children of God, when you feel like giving up. There are times, children of God, when you feel like going forward, when you feel like trying again is just a waste of time. When you feel like living this life, you don't want to be here anymore. But it is important whom you surround yourself with. This man was a paralytic, but blessed be the name of the Lord that he surrounded himself with faith carriers. I want to speak to somebody today that find yourself faith carriers. When your faith can't carry you, your faith can carry you. The Bible says this man was a paralytic, but this man began to carry him. They said, if you can't get there yourself, we will make sure that you get there. If you can't pray yourself, we will make sure that we pray with you. If you can't worship yourself, oh my God, there are times where you can't worship, where you need a song, but the song is not coming. Where you need a word, but the word is not coming. And you need a brother and a sister who will say, when you are down, but we are there to carry you. The Bible says, a righteous man may fall seven times, and seven times he will rise again. But what do you do when you can't rise yourself? It is important that you surround yourself with people that will be able to speak life into you. People that will not agree with your situation. Oh my God, oh, I need to dwell on this more. You need to surround yourself with people that do not agree with your negativity. People who will say to you, but you know, we can see you have tried everything. This thing is not working. Remember Job, in Job chapter 3, verse number 9, the Bible says, when he had lost everything, his wife said, are you still holding on your integrity? Curse God and die. You don't need such kind of people in your life. People who will encourage you to curse God and die. I need to ask Job's wife. Job is the one that married you. When he dies, whom are you going to remain yourself with? Just curse God and die. But it was not so. The Bible says, this paralytic had surrounded himself with men. He could not get there. But this man says, we will make sure that you must get there. You must surround yourself with people that push you to your destiny. You must surround yourself with people that will push you to your promised land. You must surround yourself with people that are able to see beyond what you see. You must surround yourself with people that do not agree with you, with your dead situation, but that will be able to see the inner man in you. Now watch this. The Bible says, this man, they brought the paralytic. Which means, remember in verse number 2, the Bible says, many gathered together and there was no longer room. But the paralytics could not come. Oh my God. I need to speak to the paralytics. Maybe you are able physically, but your spirit is in a paralyzed state. Your faith is in a paralyzed state. You need faith carriers, my brother. You need faith carriers, my sister. You need sisters that will carry you in faith in the midnight hour. Sisters, brothers that will wake up and begin to pray on your behalf. Sisters that will surround you and say, remember Stephen? When was stoned to death, the Bible says, and the disciples surrounded him. When the disciples surrounded him, and he began to stand up again. He stood up because he was surrounded. You need people to surround you. When all hope is lost, when faith is lost, you need people that will be able to surround you. Let's continue. The Bible says, but there was a problem. They carried him indeed, and they arrived at the house. They arrived at the church, at the synagogue where Jesus was preaching. They came to Jesus. Oh my God. They came to you. You need to remind people who you came to. Don't be discouraged by those you find at the house. because you did not come to them. You came to Jesus. Listen, the Bible says, when they came to him, bringing a paralytic who was carried by four men, when they could not come near him because of the crowd. Hello? Number one, watch this. They came to Jesus, but they could not come near him. Why? Because of the crowd. They came, it would be easy for them just to bring this man and say, Jesus, please lay your hands on this man. But they could not even arrive next to Jesus. Do you know there are times where you want to arrive next to Jesus and situations stop you? Circumstances stop you. Your heart is saying, I need to press my way forward there. But situations happen. Even if you want to press there, Apostle Dr. Maxwell Masakona has got a book. He says, turning your breakdowns into your breakthroughs. He says, when life does not afford you a chance to go over, to go around, to go under, you need to break through. But what do you do? Even when you want to penetrate and break through, you want to be like the woman who had the issue of blood, who managed to press her way in and touch the hem of Jesus. But this time around, it is not possible to penetrate through and touch the hem of Jesus. You can't get to him. What do you need, my brother, my sister? You need a desperate faith. It would have been easier for this man to turn back and say, we could not touch him. We could not get to him. And maybe I'm talking to you today. You turned back at the door. You turned back at the entrance. It was just quarter to. You turned back because you could not get back. Let me tell you something. I'm here to bring a word to you. The fact that it has not yet been done does not mean that it's not doable. The fact that others have not done it, your faith can pioneer a new way. Your faith can make a way where there is no way. Your faith can do things that have never been done before. What does the Bible say? No eye has seen, no ear has heard what the Lord has in store for you. It is hidden. It is hidden. It is waiting for you to penetrate. Now, listen, the Bible says, when this man arrived at the door, they could not even get to come to near to Jesus because of the crowd. Number two, the Bible says, it was not only because of the crowd. They could not come near to Jesus because even to get closer to the door, they could not get to the door. Let me tell you something. Many a times, wherever you need to get a miracle, you will always find a crowd. Let me bring this scenario to you. A man who wants to get a honeycomb must be able to be prepared to be beaten by bees. And every honey is always surrounded by a swarm of bees. But you need to penetrate your hand through that swarm of bees. When you have been beaten, but you still don't give up. When you have been beaten, but you know the objective. You must understand, child of God, when you come in the presence of Jesus, I don't care how much of a crowd has surrounded you. I don't care how much of a crowd is speaking into your life. I don't care how much of a crowd is standing against you, but you need to penetrate your way. You need to keep on pressing. If you can't go under, you need to go above. If you can't go around, you need to go through. If you can't go through, you need to go above. You cannot leave the house until you go. But the problem here is, how desperate are you? How bad do you want it? How much do you want it? A desperate faith will make a way. A desperate faith will make other means. A desperate faith will make other plans. A desperate faith says, if I can pray in the morning, I will pray in the evening. A desperate faith says, if I can worship in the church, I will worship in my room. A desperate faith says, if they can employ me today, I will keep on applying. I will keep on trying again. I have come to speak to somebody who has given up, and you said, but I went, it never went, but I went, I could not touch it. Child of God, make a way where there is. How desperate are you? How bad do you want it? If you want it, if God has spoken it to you in your spirit, your faith must be desperate. Your faith must be able to say, if God said it, he will not lie. If God said it, he who began a good work in you, he is faithful to see it to completion. It is not for you to see it to completion. He must see it to completion. You did not begin the work. You did not speak the word. He who spoke the word, he will see it to completion. But the question is, how desperate are you? Are you for it? Have you given up on your marriage? Have you given up on your job? Have you given up on that business idea? Have you given up on your relationship? Have you given up on your child? Oh, child of God, you need desperate faith. You remember the name of Jacob. He wrestled with God until daybreak. And then the angel said, leave me, for it is about to be daybreak. But he said, I will not let you go until you bless me, until you arrive at your until moment. You've got no reason to give up. Until you arrive at your until moment, you've got no reason to shut the door. The fact that the door is shut does not mean that it is locked. How desperate do you want it? How bad do you want it? Baby girl, if you want it, you will get it. If you want it, it is yours. It all matters how bad do you want it. Now watch this. The Bible says, they could not come inside where Jesus was because of the crowd. But check the desperate faith. Look how faith that is desperate does. The Bible says, then they uncovered the roof where Jesus was. So when they had broken, and oh my God, I love this word. It says, so when they had broken through, when they had broken through, listen. According to the structural building, there was already a door made, a man-made door. But according to the faith structure, there had to be a faith-made door. Oh, that is a word for somebody right there. That there had to be a faith-made door. Let me tell you something. People will block what the way that they made for you. People will block that which they see with their physical eyes. But there is something that faith can see. The Bible says when these men arrived, they could see that there is no way to enter here. But they said, if there is no way, there must be another way. I've come to tell you, I've come to talk to you that there must be another way for that miracle. There must be another way for your family. There must be another way for that business. That if God has spoken it, gonna make a way. When the Israelites were going to Canaan, when they arrived in front of the Red Sea, remember the Israelites said to Moses, were there no graves in Egypt? Did you bring us here to die? But what they did not know is that there is another way. Yeah, the fact that you don't see it does not mean that it's not there. And God said to Moses, why do you cry to me? Lift, stretch out your hand, stretch out your rod. You will see another way. Right in that Red Sea, there is another way. It looks like there is no way, but I've come to tell you, stand there, wait for God ordained time. There is another way. In the wedding of Cana, when the wine ran dry and people think the wedding was over, and the mother of Jesus said to Jesus, there is no more wine. And Jesus, my hour has not yet come. Woman, what do I have to do with you? What business do I have to do with you? But the mother of Jesus, oh, the woman who had a desperate faith, the woman who kept the faith, goes back to the seventh and says, whatsoever he tells you to do, just do it. That was a woman of faith. That was a woman who refused to give up. Just because Jesus answered me in a cheeky way does not mean that he's not gonna do. There must be another way. Remember Jesus, the Bible says, he then spoke to the servant and said, fill the gallons with water. Another way. And the another way of your miracle is always an unusual way. When faith is desperate, it will always operate in unusual way. When faith is desperate, it will always operate in extraordinary ways. When faith is desperate, it will always operate in uncommon norms. Things that are not usual to men. Do not, when you are operating out of desperate faith, don't expect people to understand you if they're not desperate. Now watch this. The Bible says, these men, they uncovered the roof. I can imagine that some of the people were even saying, what are you doing to the roof? But they did not understand. We've got an emergency case here. They did not understand that we brought a man here. We are not coming in with a situation and going out with the same situation. Child of God, you must be desperate. You must be desperate for that situation. Your faith must be desperate. You can't come at the pool of Bethesda. You can't come in the presence of the Lord and live the same. Let your faith arise. You can't come in the presence of the Lord and live with that sickness. You can come in the presence of the Lord and live with that depression in the name of Jesus Christ. Your depression must leave you in the presence of the Lord. Everything is possible. How desperate do you want it? You need to come out of that cocoon. You need to that place of average. You need to come out of that place of disappointment. Your faith must arise and say, I'm desperate for you, Lord. Listen, the Bible says, these men, they uncovered the roof. Whether it was a tiny roof, they were taking tile by tile. Where was the paralytic man? The paralytic man could not move himself. But the man, the faith carrier says, even if you can't do it, we will make a way where there is no way. The Bible says, after they had uncovered the roof, not only uncovering the roof, but listen, there's a word here. The Bible says, so when they had broken through, after uncovering, your faith must break through. After uncovering, your faith must penetrate. It is not only about the uncovering and showing off that you can do it, but after you have uncovered, you must penetrate. Oh, they started the harvest in Johannesburg. They thought they could stop church. But let me tell you something. We are sitting here delivering the word right into your family every church Wednesday. Why? Because we must penetrate. There must be another. No, Makanjani, my sister, you can't give up. There must be another way. And another way is made out of a desperate faith. How desperate are you? Whose report would you believe? Whose word are you standing on? I know the enemy is saying it's impossible. But God is saying it's possible. How shall this be? Remember when the angel appeared to Mary and says, blessed among men are you, woman. You shall conceive and you shall give birth to a son and you shall name him Jesus. And Mary says, how shall this be? And the angel says, the Spirit of the Lord will come upon you. This son will not be born out of man. According to by the biological order, a woman will only give birth when she meets a man. But for you, child of God, it is not about the biological order. It's not about the biological time. It's not about the economical season. It's about the Spirit of the Lord making things out of nothing. But that will only happen. How bad do you want it? How desperate are you for it? You need a desperate faith. You need a faith that will decide. Remember, desperation is having a great need. How big is your need? Hannah went to Shiloh in the midst of Penina. When Penina was busy criticizing her, when Penina was busy mocking her, but because she had a great need, because she was desperate, she went into the temple. She prayed until the man of God Eli, for she was drunk. The drunkenness in her prayer was not made by alcohol. It was because she was desperate. How bad do you want it? How bad do you want it? If you want it bad, you're gonna get it. How big is that need? The bigger the need, the bigger the desperation. The bigger the need, the bigger the faith. The bigger the need. How big is your need? Stop playing around chickens. Stop playing around people that have no bigger needs. You've got a bigger need that will require. It will require a bigger faith out of you. It will require a desperate faith out of you. Listen, the Bible says, when this man broke through, they let down the band. Oh my God. The paralytic was not doing anything. The paralytic was just sleeping on the bed. But the man says, you people that tried to block us, remember, when they were uncovering the roof, those that blocked the door, they were still there. When they broke through the roof, those that stopped them, those that became stumbling block against them to get to Jesus, they were still there. But they say, even in the midst of criticizing, I don't know what these men were saying. I don't know how much they were criticizing them. They were saying, he's about to finish preaching. You are just wasting your time. He's already prayed for the sick. You are just wasting your time. But this man kept on focusing on their faith. Kept on focusing on their faith. After they finished breaking through, the Bible says they took the paralytic man. They let him down. What was letting him down? Desperate faith was letting him down. Desperate, slowly but surely, Jesus was continuing preaching. I don't know whether Jesus was disturbed and kept on looking up and said, I want to see how much will they do it. I want to see how far can they go. Oh, I hear the Lord says, I'm looking at your situation, baby. I'm looking at you. How far can you go with it? How far can you depend on me? How far can you trust me? How far can you believe in me? How far can you still stand on the word in the midst of criticism, in the midst of unhealing sickness, in the midst of unemployment, in the midst of everything that is fighting against you, in the midst of haters? Oh, how far can you still stand when you have lost everything, when people that were BFFs are no longer there, when people that were your helpers are no longer there, when you are paralyzed? from top to bottom, but can you still get down when you are stuck, when you are blocked to come to Jesus, but you can still make a way to get there? Jesus is watching you. I want to see how far can your faith go? How desperate are you for it? And when Jesus was looking, all the men kept on coming. They brought him down. What was bringing him down? It was a desperate faith. It was a desperate faith that broke through. It was a desperate faith that made a way. And I want to say today to you, this Wednesday, your faith can be desperate. This Wednesday, you can stand up and say, I gave up on it. I'm going back. I'm hitting on the same day. I'm hitting on the same spot. Until I get my breakthrough, I am not giving up. Until I get that which God has spoken, I am not giving up. Until my prayer is answered, I am not letting go. The Bible said, as soon as the men arrived, come on, watch this. The man that brought the paralytic never went to Jesus. It was the paralytic. God, it was the paralytic that went to Jesus. Listen. It is not for you to get to Jesus. Your issue must get to Jesus. I must say it again. It is not for you to get to Jesus. Your issue must come head on condition with Jesus. Your faith must come head on condition with Jesus. Your problem must come head on condition with Jesus. It must be. It's not about you appearing all good and all well before Jesus. Take your issue. Present your issue to Jesus. Take your issue must be right in the face of Jesus. This man, they came with faith, but they came with a paralytic man. They dropped him down. They let him down. Watch this. The Bible says, when Jesus saw their faith, I told you, he was looking. And he was not merely looking at them, he was looking at faith. He wanted to see how far can this faith go. Let me ask you a question. How far have you went with faith? I'm not talking about Christianity. All of us can confess that we're Christians. But can you still be a Christian in China, where they're killing, where you worship heathen, where they have church underground? How far can you go with your faith? The Bible says, when Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, son, your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven, my God. This man came for healing. But because he was desperate, but because he came in a desperate situation, Jesus honored the desperate faith. And he says, I know you did not come for the healing of sins, but you, because of the faith that I saw, because of the desperate faith, he says, your sins are forgiven. How desperate is your faith? I read for you Mark chapter 10. Bartimaeus, he was born, he was seated there by the roadside. People were laughing at him, but when he heard it was Jesus who was passing by, Bartimaeus says, when he heard, he did not care what others have heard, but when he heard that it was Jesus that was passing by, the Bible says he began to shout, and not only shout, but he began to shout all the more. That shows you that he was desperate. He shouted for the first time. Maybe Jesus did not hear, he could not see, but he said, I will use the tool that I have. He could not see, but he says, my mouth can still speak. He shouted the more. He was desperate. And when he was desperate, he shouted the more. The Bible says they even tried to quiet him down, but he never listened to them. I'm here to say to you, thing that you are desperate for, when you are desperate for that miracle, don't listen to what people are saying. Let me tell you something. When your issue arrives at Jesus, Jesus will even take care of the things that you did not ask him for. But it all matters how desperate you are for it. The Bible says, when Bartimaeus began to shout them all, when he shouted, Jesus was continuing his journey. But when he heard the shout, oh, can I talk to you, mama? Lift up your voice. Let Jesus hear that shout in that hospital bed. When you are lying in that situation, let Jesus hear your shout. Lift up your voice. Let Jesus is waiting for you to shout. The Bible says, and Jesus stood still. Oh, let me tell you something. When you are desperate, your desperation can stop Jesus. Your desperation can interrupt the program of heaven. The Jesus ministry was interrupted by a desperate man. He stopped Jesus, and the Bible said, and Jesus called him. He said he must be called. He commanded him to be called. He was not yet there, but he was called. Those people that were quieting him down, they were the same people that went to him and said, he is calling you. Rise up and go. He went to Jesus. How desperate want it? Do you have a desperate faith? When you are desperate for it, Jesus is going to stop for you. Jesus will stop everything for you. Hey, tonight I want to speak to you that Jesus, the heavenly program, can stop for you. If you are desperate for it, you can keep on pursuing. You can keep on pushing. Pray until something happens. If it has not yet happened, which means I am not yet done. If I have not hold it, which means I have not yet arrived. If I have not had my answer, which means I have not, my fight is not finished. My battle is not over. It is not over until God says it's over. I've come to tell you, it is not over until you touch it with your own hand. It is not over until you receive it, until you see it, until you walk into your promised land. But it will only take the people that are desperate. It will only take the desperate faith that will continue pushing, that will continue moving, that will continue penetrating. I've come to tell you, my sister, my brother, maybe your parents are no more, and everybody that said they will take you to school, they are no longer there. Let faith penetrate. Be desperate. Let your faith make a way where there is no way. Let your faith make other plans in accordance to faith. That's how God is going to operate in your life. How desperate are you for it? Desperation. It's a great need with a great desire for something. What are you desiring God for? What are you desperate to God for? What do you want God to do for you? How bad do you want it? There are times where people won't understand you. People that you are expecting them to stand with you, they won't stand with you. And when all is lost, you need a desperate faith. How desperate do you want it? I want you to come out. Come out of the crowd. If you have to shout, shout. If you have to call to your destiny, call to your destiny. If you have to weep to your destiny, weep to your destiny, baby. But how bad do you want it? If you have to be ruled out and be called a stupid girl and be called a stupid boy, do it. But how bad do you want it? It's your desperation that will separate you from the crowd. It's your desperation that will make you stand out from the crowd. I want to pray with somebody today. Desperate faith. That's all you need. Desperate faith. I know you're weak. Your body is weak. You see, Pastor, but I've tried everything. But your faith must be desperate. How desperate do you have? How much of desperation do you have in your life? How much can you still push? God is waiting for you to be desperate. I remember Paul and Silas, beaten, oozing with blood, imprisoned in jail. Oh, but they worshipped. They worshipped. If it was me and you, we would have succumbed to the situation. We would have succumbed to everything that was happening. It says, it is over. I've come to say to you, Mama, Papa, it's not over. Until God has said, it is not the end of your life. How desperate do you want it? Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I release the desperate faith. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for my brother, I pray for my sister, oh God. That, oh God, in the name of Jesus, let the desperate faith arise. Let in the name of Jesus, right in that situation, she's not giving up, right in that situation, she's not letting go, right in that situation, you are not listening to the crowd. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that, oh God, may a way be made. For weeping may endure for a night, but joy is coming in the morning, but it will only come to those that are desperate. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, that, oh God, nobody shall give up. Let faith arise, let desperate faith arise, in the name of Jesus Christ. That, oh God, even when there is no way through the door, a way shall be made. Mighty God, from the roof, there shall be another way. In the mighty name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, in the midst of skybus, I pray in Jesus' name. That, oh God, let there be another way. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Remember, after this man was healed, the skybus began to speak. Hear me now. As soon as you begin to operate your faith, you activate haters. They will begin to speak because you have decided to do that which they could not. Stand out. Come out of the average in the name of Jesus Christ. We will see you next week. Same time, same place. You can just follow us on our YouTube page, follow us on our Instagram page, follow us on our Twitter page. The details are on the screen right now. God richly bless you. Amen.